Good to see you, Hunter. We are in Hemmeldal, and once again, the large calibers come out, because here we want to check out the brown bear barrel. This is the best place that I found here in Hemmeldal, and looking at the map, this is where this is, up in the north. In the meantime, Val de Bois has come out. They also feature brown bears over there, and there's also very good places there. But once again, I want to make the comparison to the old days. So far, I've done the Feral Hawk and Logger's Point. I would not go in the future for baiting ferals there. I would likely go to Bush Rangers. Black bears was really good. I thought it was good. I had 4 bears at one point at the feeder. And for brown bears, I think this still used to be my favorite place here, even though Val de Bois also being available for brown bear hunting and baiting. This is a good setup. I like it. And so I want to check this out. I will do at least 3 hunts and see how they go. If they're all consistent, that's going to be good enough. Maybe we'll do a 4th. That depends on how it goes. As a quick summary, what has changed with the baiting? There used to be attractiveness that used to grow over 7 days, pretty much 15% every day. So you had to wait for a whole week to find out if your place was good. Even though you would see early on whether it would go to 100%, you would still not be sure whether animals would come. So really all barrel tests had to go through the full 7 days. When you saw there was a good place, a 100% place, you would still have to check whether animals are actually coming. This is different now. The feeder is active 4 hours after placing. Actually, after placing the food in it. And then it's fully attracting, and you can tell after 4 hours whether it's good or not. The other thing that changed was the penalty. With the attractiveness, it would drop down to 25% and then grow within 2 days back to the top. Here with the new version, you have a 30-minute penalty, and then the feeder is fully active again. The attraction radius would grow with the attractiveness. This is also different because now the feeder is active. That means 100% attraction, and you have the 150 meters attraction radius for goats and 250 meters for feral hogs, wild boars, brown bears, and black bears. And while I'm talking, I should worry about the feeder. I should crouch from here. There's always satellite bears. I have a flock of willow ptarmigans. They're either fleeing or migrating. So coming up here on a good day, I would have satellite bears already. I am seeing one. Where are you? Maybe all the way over at the barrel. Oh, there it is. So one bear is near the feeder. The max weight for brown bear is 490 something kilograms. And the max score is almost 29. So everything over 28 is a really good bear. And I was really lucky last night during doing the black bears. Anything between 23 and 24 is a great bear. And I actually ended up shooting a 23. It's still ranked 3rd in the competition there. So that was pretty good. It's really luck as well. You can have many, many bears with nothing. with no good scores, but I ended up having one in my third hunt. No, it was the second hunt, and then I had to wait for 30 minutes. But that's not a big deal. Now we have tracks here from the ptarmigans. I have to be really careful. But even if I end up spooking the bears, I will still do the same exercise. I will just count. How many tracks do we have? Tracks of how many different bears do we have at the feeder? That is really the more interesting number than the actual bears at the feeder. So we really only seem to have this one bear. It's not huge. So there's certainly not a whole lot of bears circling and waiting. They would likely join in no matter what size. Oh, there are two bears. So this one is a little bit larger, but still not great. There comes number three. All the medium size. But this is looking pretty good, I would say. So the play still works. And once again, if you have good places, make a post below the video. Tell us what the reserve and what the coordinates are. That's helpful. Or at least roughly where you placed it, near some lake or whatever. So we have three bears right at the feeder. And now I'm going to do my run over. If you run like this, they will spook. If you come close, crouching, they might attack. But right now, I mean, come on, me against three bears, they have to run. Nah, they should really act a bit different, but oh well. So, number one. Two. Three. Back in the good days, I really had 7-8 different tracks, different bears. But we've already seen with the black bears and the feral hawks, these numbers have certainly come down. Baiting has been made easier. It's really easy to understand. It's easy to set up. Not much testing going on. But the disadvantage to before is overall, less animals are attracted. The feeder is also supposed to spawn animals. So I'm thinking this is in a good area with bears regardless of the feeder. Now, if you add a feeder, I would expect a couple more bears. At least old tracks that have been at the feeder and then moved on. But this is a total of... Oh, there is a fourth bear calling. It's the red fox bear. No, we still really only have three bears. And I'm out of tracks. So I'm going to say we found three tracks and all the three bears right there. Let's start hunt number two. We are back for hunt number two. I didn't mention the starting time before. It is 11 o'clock. Doesn't matter that much for the Bears. But back in the old days when I did a lot of competitions and I went to the feeder for 10 times really during a competition, I must have done a few hundred walks. And what I've noticed was that hunts that start before 11 have a lot of moose, and then after 11 you have more roe deer. This, however, was even before the introduction of reindeer, which pushes out a few of the animals. And now we also have the willow ptarmigan. In the hunt before, we had ptarmigans only. I didn't see... Actually, I had a red fox, which I was surprised to hear. That's certainly a guy that has walked over from the east. That is not usual to have red fox. Usually the predominant animals here are mule deer, moose and roe deer. And combined, it's moose deer. No, no, there's no mule deer in the European map. Again, this is the feeder location. Just looking around, and in case we did have a reindeer or a roe deer, that 308 carbon comes along. I should load up the 340 Weatherby for good bears or moose. And if an animal comes too close, the 308 handgun. Not much activity. The first call would always come here within the first few minutes. So I'm going to say moose is going to call in 10, 9, 8. No, no, I'm just kidding. But the first call is overdue. Maybe because there's so many bears here. The first hunt was really good. Three bears right there. When the baiting was still overacting, overreacting, overperforming, I had six bears sometimes, so that was certainly too much. In fact, I've won a competition once with shooting three bears at the barrel. It was a weight competition where you need the three heaviest, and I could shoot all three bears right there and I won the competition. That was like super rare. You can only imagine, somebody suggested I must have cheated. But if you do hundreds and hundreds of walks to your barrel, you can see these instances. I had found some silver-tipped bears. And now I should be careful because I can hear a brown bear. Once again, this is satellite roaming area. Very common to have bears. And in fact, I should just spook it away, but it's not ideally placed down there. No, it's too close. The angle is not good. That is a good size, over 400 kilograms likely. I hear another one. That is not the only bear there. I think one just walked over the hill. When they read it, the bear look, when they went away from the plastic bear to the plush bear, you can see the fur looks much better. They also added some noises. The black bear now moans after spooked, and the brown bear, black bear, and grizzly bear, you can hear breathe. Now this one is even better. Look at the weight. Again, max weight is somewhere around 490. This one would likely score 27. Nice big bears. Let's just make sure this one doesn't spook and spoil the party. Ooh, I can spot another one. Maybe that's the heavy breather from before. No, she's up there. I can hear the breathing from over here somewhere. So I'm thinking this time we have at least four tracks at the barrel. There's another bear at the barrel. I just spotted a 310 to something. So the fat guy is not alone. My goal is to reach the tripod. Up on there, you're almost invisible. It's really interesting. Because it's a large bear, I would think it's gonna go to the barrel. It's large enough to cope with the fat guy that's there right now. If it was a small bear, I could pretty much be sure it's gonna turn around and keep circling around the feeder. But this fat boy will certainly go over. It's about time you call. So this must be the big one. That's the one that we observed walking over. This is the 310 I had in the spot. So this one is the largest. Can we get to four bears? Now this one is trotting out. Now it's gonna come back. This is certainly not the size of bear that would flee from others. And if this was the third hunt, I would actually shoot the two large ones. I think I can get two with the 340. But this is only hunt number two. All right, no more bears coming. This is number two. This is number three. No, that's the moose bear. This is number 3. Four. I still think we should have 5. By the way, look at these footprints. This is the heavy one. This is the footprint of the heavy. And now look at the footprint of the small one. This one is a small one. You can see there's a difference in size. And that's helping you when your tracking skill is still low. Look at the footprints. And if you see these large footprints, that's one to go after. So I'm still at 4 bears. Here is number 5. As expected, the heavy breathing bear also must be somewhere. Did we have the female, the small female? This is also a good size bear. Number 6, 1 hour ago. So I'm going to check out the hill up here. And then we've circled the barrel enough. There you go, number 7. This could be the small female that we saw. I'm not sure. Because once you spot it, the weight estimation should have a lower range, smaller range. Because spotting is more accurate than tracking. Could be the one, I don't know, but it's number 7. That's pretty cool. 7 tracks. I'm happy to see my place is still a good one. So let's start hunt number 3. Off we go once more. I'm actually very glad we only have 3 sessions for these videos. Because I'm out of text, I'm out of information. The baiting is so simple now, it's really explained in a few minutes. The only thing I haven't touched on is if you are a stand hunter, you want to hunt over a barrel or a hog feeder. That has been a bit of a concern. In the old system, you would have full attraction, for example. You could start your hunt and then shoot animals all day long. Within the running session, the attraction would never drop. It would always stay at 100%. Animals would keep coming back. Even though they were spooked by a shot or bow shot, they would come back. And you could hunt 6-7 bears and more at the barrel. And now with the new penalty system, that is not as easy anymore. You shoot an animal, especially with the bow, it's certainly just one. And then you have to wait for 30 minutes for the penalty to disappear. And then the feeder is going to start a track again. So after a shot, it might be a good 30, 35 to 40 minutes maybe until you see the next animal. 30 minutes to restore the penalty or the attraction, and another 5 to 10 minutes until actually animals would come. So that's an argument. Stand hunting isn't really that good anymore. However, if you kept the penalty throughout the session, that wasn't really good. I think actually that was a design flaw. The penalty should have applied right after the shot, even within the running session. It never did. People took advantage of it. And then when he was away, they said, now it's broken. Now stand hunting doesn't work anymore, but it worked actually a bit too well before. So I'm surprised very few moose. I'm not amused with the moose. No roe deer so far. I should have started a hunt at 12. So maybe we should have seen a difference. And also no reindeer so far. Again, no call. And again, I've been doing this hundreds of times. By this time, I would always have had a call. There's currently a long shot competition, so even if there's a large bear, it's not going to do anything for any competitions. But that's not the main reason for coming. There you go, the roe deer. Did it say female? Yes. Well, I'm not going to attract it anyway. I will hopefully be able to shoot a bear or two, because after this visit I'm not gonna use the feeder anymore. Oh, there's a bear. Medium size. It's a rather open area. And then we're looking into the a bit thicker woods here. But I tried so many places in open areas, on hills, in valleys. This turned out to be the best. So what have we got? Wow, another large bear. And what else? Ah, yeah, that's right, the roe deer. Thanks for reminding me, but look at this. Just one bear. So after the three bears with rather decent sizes and seven tracks at the barrel in the last session, this one turns out to be disappointing. We have one coming in. There it is. It's moved closer. So we will end up with two bears here for a moment. The roe deer is going to be shocked by the shooting. Hopefully the bears won't be shocked too long. The 340 is really a major rifle. It's the super gun here alongside the 4570s. Really reliable on large game. How long does it take you, buddy? Oh, this is good. It's gonna walk straight before me here. So I have plenty of time to shoot it while it's running. Where's the other? No. All right, let's go. And the feeder is kaput. The attraction is now zero. What it does technically, it sets the attraction radius to 0 meters. So a bear sitting on top of the barrel might still be attracted. I'm gonna pick them up. Not the best shot here. I hope the second was better. Intestines, I was too late. Which are you now? I don't want to... Yeah, it's my beer. I don't want to pick up the wrong beer and then kill a set of tracks. Okay, it's the bear I'm following, so I can pick it up. So this is number two here. Three. It's this one. Intestines. What a bad shooter. I wanted to get the lungs. What else have we got? Four. Four tracks only. Can you believe you can aim at a slowly walking bear and you can't manage the lungs? So intestines is always bad, especially when you hit the stomach. Sometimes it seems you'd rather hit the front leg or something. So this now goes slowly down, and just when you think the bear must be dead now, you have made half of the distance. Oh, what a bad shot. Come on, now the health doesn't even drop anymore. More moose. Here we go. So only 4 beers. That's really not much. There it is. So today's ending will be 3 lines instead of 2. This was it. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave some comments. 4 beers is not much. Anyway, stay in touch. Thank you very much.